Understanding color blindness. Color blindness is as old as the human being, but it was only in the 18th century that a scientist suffering from this anomaly described it scientifically. His name was John Dalton, which is why color blindness is also known as Daltonism. Here you can see the anatomy of the human eye. Sclera. It is what surrounds the eye, giving it protection and support. Cornea. It is a transparent structure that covers the anterior sixth of the eye. The transition to the sclera is progressive. Lens. The anterior and posterior faces of the lens form a biconvex structure that allows the passage of light into the eye. Iris. Located in front of the lens, it is the muscle on the pupillary edge that allows more or less light to pass into the eye. Pupil. Opening in the iris that allows the passage of light into the eye. Ciliary body. It consists of the ciliary processes that produce the aqueous humor, fluid between the cornea and the iris, and the ciliary muscle, responsible for the accommodation process, where the ligaments of the lens are attached. Through their traction, the change in the lens geometry allows focusing. Retina. It is the fundamental structure of the eye, subdivided into two parts. The peripheral section is where photoreceptors known as rods predominate. The central section is where cones are more abundant. The rods are sensitive to low light, giving a low resolution and achromatic vision. The cones are activated by relatively high luminous intensities, providing a high-resolution color vision. Macule. In this area of the retina, there are only cones and corresponds to the area of highest visual acuity, 9 to 13 angular opening in the visual field. Vitreous humor. It is a transparent gelatinous mass that guarantees the eye its globular shape, crossed at its center by a thin canal called the hyoid canal. Choroid. It is located behind the retina and nourishes it through a vascular ball. Optic nerve. The optic nerve sends the inverted image captured by the eyes to the brain. Then, the brain interprets the image. What causes color blindness? The cones have different sensitivities, capturing light at different wavelengths. Some cones capture long waves, red, others short waves, blue and violet, and others intermediate lengths, yellow and green. In a colorblind person, there is a lack of one or more types of cones, or at least problems in their normal functioning. Dietrinopia, common. Called Dietrinopia or anomalous trichromacy, is the absence or deficiency of cones sensible to intermediate waves, yellow and green, resulting in the inability to distinguish red from green. Magenta and cyan are also challenging to identify. Protonopia, rare. Called protonomaly or anomalous trichromacy, is the absence or deficiency of cones sensible to long waves, red, resulting in another form of inability to distinguish red from green. Cyan and magenta appear to be the same color, changed only in terms of luminosity. Yellow and green are also barely distinguishable. They seem to be the same color, changed only concerning luminosity. Tritonopia, very rare, called tritonomaly, is the absence or deficiency of cones sensible to short waves, blue and violet, resulting in the inability to distinguish blue from green. Cyan and green appear to be the same color, changed only concerning luminosity. achromatopsia, very rare. It is a pathological state of vision in which the individual cannot distinguish colors due to the scarcity of cones in the retina and sensitive only to the presence of light. Note that in the addictive mixture, the secondary colors distinguish remotely from each other. In the subtractive mixing, the cyan, green, red, and magenta are also very difficult to detect.